Zambia, like the rest of the countries around the world, is entering an exciting era of history where citizens are developing a new mindset and rising to the challenge to make a difference in their communities. Diverse challenges have continued to exist in Zambia, especially in the health and education sectors. In Masaiti District, in the Copperbelt province, for instance, it is common to find cases of people walking long distances to access crucial services. Makeshift facilities are devised where a scale hangs on a tree for weighing under 5 children. It's also a common feature to find pupils learning in thatched structures under a tree or in buildings that were initially set up as temporal measures many decades ago. In Mutaba ward of Masaiti District, near the border with the Democratic Republic of Congo DRC, lays an institution of learning known as Good Fellow Community School. This school only has 2 classrooms, where very often lessons for grade 6, 4 and 2 are held at the same time, in the same class and under the same dreadful building. A precarious situation hangs over the pupils and teachers as the building under which they learn is only held in place by planks and other items.
We had problems here and there. When rains comes, you find that pupils in class, our books in the office, they will get soaked, and the fear of the block itself to corrupt on us.
Ever since we opened this school, I've struggled a lot because the area and the people within this community are not very much concerned. So as a result, we are lacking all the facilities that are needed at this school.
The school got only one block, which has got 3 classrooms, which doesn't accommodate most of the pupils. As a result, some pupils, they learn under the tree because of such.
It is this and many other challenges that have inspired Masaiti Council Chairperson Christine Chande Kalumbwa to mobilize personal finances, resources and other materials to set up houses and classroom blocks at more than 10 schools in the district. This move does not only guarantee improved education standards, but also promotes the safety of the pupils.
When I came to this school, Goodfellow, the first thing that caught my eye was the infrastructure of the school. It is so bad that any time this building will fall, our children, if it was my kid learning in that infrastructure, how would I feel? I wouldn't want my child to be in such a structure. We in Masaiti District, me in particular, I'm so touched by such things. That's why I want this school to change. We are building this 1x2 and the 1x3 so that our kids can learn in good infrastructure.
That's why now when I put the fire, Pangi is so mild. I put the tin and Tiami Ponena. To allow Bombelapo, Pacutida, Ubuteco, Wesu, Government Yesu, either fire Mueva, and Nama Sambi that we know. Mother Sambi lo Musuma, that's why to the food is a school.
The lower learning institutions that have benefited from this goodwill are community schools, namely Yande, Nselala, and Goodfellow, while the primary schools are Katinino, Ifulumo, Mpulawushi, Fubude, Mumana, Muteteshi, Munyemesha, and Lumano. 3-bedroom teachers' houses at Munyemesha, Mwanawasa School, Bangwe, and 2-bedroom houses at Nkambo Community School and Mpulawushi are also being constructed under the same project by the Masaiti Council Chairperson.
We have 5 classrooms against 712 pupils. Our school runs from grade 1 to 9. So our pupils have challenges in fitting into these classrooms.
The mayor, herself, Mrs. Christine, she has really come to our aid, because right now we have started building 1x3 classroom block. And we are really happy because this will help us to increase, so to say, on the number of classes. In that way, it will be easy for us to teach properly.
I want to do more for Masaiti. I want to do more for the girl child. I want to do more for the people of Masaiti. When I go to a certain place and I find that kids are learning under a tree, I make sure I jot that place down and I tell the people right there and then to help me to mold the bricks so that we start building.
These projects blend well with the government's development idea of not leaving anyone behind, as espoused in the Seventh National Development Plan. Christine Chande explains the motivation behind these projects.
Lack of infrastructure, children learning under a tree, that wouldn't inspire the girl child to go to school. But if they knew there was a classroom block existing somewhere, then that child would go to school. So the girl child was number one, and then children going to school in general, that's what made me start doing what I'm doing.
Working with the community to mold bricks and thereafter setting up the infrastructure, Christine Chande, a mother of four, stresses that her desire is to see every girl child being educated in the district for meaningful progress and development.
I want change in Masaiti, because in these rural districts that we have, they don't consider girl children that much, the girl child, because they feel the girl child has to do the house chores, has to do those chores and then get married. But I feel the girl child has to get educated the most, because she can do more for the community.
During a handover ceremony for a 1x2 classroom block at Munyemesha School, a project that was done in honor of Chief Mushili of the Lamba people, Christine Chande reaffirmed her stance on the girl child while challenging leaders across the country, especially women, to work diligently and complement government's efforts towards benefiting the people of Zambia.
My wish is to make Masaiti educated in any way that I can. Inenshufo bwinonga namona bana balesambilira muma chechi mufimuti ifa muna muma rural district ama skulu ya alibapatari ya alisalangana tufuire tuambo kubombela mukutwara ama skulu munchende echa tunefaila ama anavesu maka maka bana bana kashi vela ukwabu wangu.
They worship the mayor of Masaiti, a district. Madam, bear in mind that your effort to develop Masaiti are not in vain. You have touched many souls in the district in a short period of time. You have also built a clinic called Kasabwa. You have also built classroom blocks at Goodfellow, Mumana, Miputu, Kyutu, and any other areas in the district. For all these efforts, I say thank you very much.
Aside from the construction of classroom blocks, the council chairperson has also partnered with local players in the education sector to ensure improved access to tertiary education in the district. A total of 100 residents have so far been awarded full tuition scholarships from Lubuto University of Luansha for various diploma and degree courses. She explains why it is important for young people to go to school before they could consider other things such as marriage or starting businesses.
Because I went to university after I'd had all my children. I think I'll change that. I'd rather go to university before the kids. because that way I'd have concentrated more on my education. But now that you've got kids, you have to look after the kids, you have to look after the husband. So that's one aspect I'll change. I'd want to go to university before the kids come.
Joseph Mwamba, who is blind and received a full scholarship to study secondary teaching, has struck a bond with the council chairperson, who empathizes with him and draws on her personal experience to address issues affecting visually impaired people in the area.
Through the office of the mayor, Kumasaiti to Alakwata Numba, he Nerubuto Sit Numba, Iquata Main Campus Kuno, Tutunala Shokirati, Naini Bakuba picked. Scholarship area, ndi uwansansa sana kutilesa ale pala kabili nobuteko bwesukuli ya pantanshi.
When I had my first child, I think, I didn't know the snake. A snake had gone into the house, gone into the cupboard, and in the pot. So I was washing plates outside, and then when I came to put the plates inside the cupboard, then I was attacked by that snake. It was a spitting cobra. So I was blind for almost a month. I think if I didn't go through that, I wouldn't have known, or I wouldn't have this passion that I have for the blind. It has made me appreciate what God has done, the creation. Because not seeing what is there, it was really tough. You find somebody to hold your hand through and through. People get tired of holding your hand, taking you and all that. It was really tough. So it has made me appreciate more. And I think in these leadership positions that we have, I think we should look after the blind and the disabled so much.
Masaiti Council Chairperson Christine Chande, who came into office in April of 2017 following a by-election, has also undertaken to help the health sector by putting up health workers' houses at Bangwe in Chondwa Ward and Katuba in Katuba Ward, a health post at Nselala in Ishitwe, and Kasabwa Weighing Post in Chilulu Ward, which she has since handed over to the community.
We as the staff at Masaiti Council Clinic, we wish to express our profound gratitude to you, Madam, and we are also urging you not to stop here. In due course, Madam, we ask that you may consider to establish Kasabwa Weighing Post to become an established health center.
Perhaps one might ask, how does Christine Chande Kalumbwa do it? How does she manage to balance and make everything around her better, in line with the International Women's Day theme? Having been married for 25 years, she credits her husband for his support to her work.
The office is the office, but once I reach the gate, the office stays. And I'm a woman, I'm a mother, I'm a wife. I have to know my duties as a woman, as a mother, as a wife. And my husband is so supportive because he knows I balance the two very well.
Nishiwe yakweva chumwana kashi. Ivingi tuli mfira munshire shapsana psana. Bachipungo chali andukati we wasanga kafwa wakwe nishari shoka. Kwena pali bonsa aba yumfo kutirati nangwa abatotira kuri leso kutirati lesali bapera abana kashi. Nani wene pona aba. Yoshuko na dikweta kuri lesa. Ndatotira sana. umyaka twayikala na bene kubacha abana bonse bakole.
Christine Chande further credits her efforts to fellow leaders in the district, particularly the two members of parliament and the district commissioner, Mike Msonda, who lauds her efforts and urges other women in the district to work together.
I'm privileged to have a number of women in decision-making positions. For example, I've worked to the council, it's been controlled by a woman, the mayor, Christine Chande. She's doing very well. We used to think that women wouldn't make good leaders. But they are there. They are performing better than even us men.
A lot of resources are going into buying of building materials, paint and labor, among others. So, how much does it all cost for the Masaiti Council Chairperson?
You know, it's like this. If I had to buy a gift or a present for someone, I'll just buy the gift and give it to that someone. I wouldn't tell that someone, I've bought you this and it costs this much. That's not a gift. You want that person to know. It's like bragging. So I wouldn't put a price to how much I'm spending in the projects that I'm doing, because it's a gift for the people that put me into this office. So there's no price when it comes to giving.
The Masaiti Council Chairperson also recognizes skills development and entrepreneurship as key tools for uplifting people's living standards, especially women in rural areas. At the Women in Business Conference in Luansha, where several institutions like Zambia Revenue Authority, ZRA, National Pension Scheme Authority, NAPSA, the Citizens Economic Empowerment Commission, CEEC, and Osho Limited were on hand to explain how businesses can utilize their products and services. The Masaiti civic leader challenged the Empowerment Commission to prioritize funding projects in rural districts to ensure equal opportunities for the people of Zambia.
Each and every part of Zambia needs your services, but I also know that rural districts need these services the most, because that's where you find the poorest of the poor people. In the rural districts. So, when do you intend spreading your wings to districts like Masaiti, for example?
Through her organization called Odini Foundation, Christine Chande has also been spearheading programs to support vulnerable people in the district, especially women, whom she says have continued making significant contributions in society by taking care of not only their own families, but other households in the community as well. She has held meetings with women groups to empower them with materials as well as knowledge and skills to assist them address ills of poverty, including gender-based violence.
The home, inlanda, a institution, idenga, today fika na muriya noma office. Gatatu ale kulabu ino, tete tufike na panopotori. So muma yanda, ababe nyaba anaba nono. Eba kababa counselor, eba kababa teacher, eba kababa mayor, no banga bale pita mu matocha, aya kutira, ababa nyaba na mule mona, ima kuti mule ti mule ro ababidi yaba lumena bakashi, abana babale kopa, aka mona tye normal lifestyle yoyina, ena kesa chila na pali yapo mwalelu ilaba nina na bawishi. So aba nebo tule chita consider mu life.
Away from her community projects, Christine Chande always wants to break the shackles of gender occupation segregation by learning to do things or works that are normally considered a preserve of men. She also draws inspiration from other women, among them the Vice President of Zambia, Mrs. Inonga Wina, and United States media mogul, Oprah Winfrey. But her mother remains her biggest inspiration.
My mother, she's made me what I am, because I used to emulate her. So she hasn't seen what I've become, what her last born has become, which is sad. But I know she'll be proud of me that my last born has made something out of her life. And so I say thank you to my mother, because she was a very strong woman. She brought us up, the 10 of us, single-handed. So my mother is the first one on that list.
Christine Chande has further advised women to aspire for political offices and leadership positions. Most of people, especially women in leadership in the district, consider her. Despite undertaking all these projects in the district, Christine Chande still does not feel it is enough. She feels the projects need to remain sustainable and go beyond her efforts. The question then is, what would Masaiti look like if it had more leaders of Christine Chande's caliber? Would this balance in leadership make the district better, or would it be more of the same?
You know, when you are not qualified as a woman, you represent women negatively, because people have a very different picture of women, that women are only given things like they don't earn these positions, instead it's ascribed. So if a woman is competent, well educated, then they are able to take up any leadership role. So I would encourage all the women to be ready to take any task that is given to them. They try it out, they learn from it, and be able to share their achievements with others.
Collective action and shared responsibility are decisive when it comes to gender advancement and securing development. Everyone, everywhere has a role to play to have a gender-balanced society. Thinking equal, building smart, and innovating for change, her firstborn son also explains the lessons he draws from his mother.
I love the fact that she's always ready to interact with the people. Yeah, she would just randomly stop anywhere, you know, talk to her people within the district, or sometimes even other places. Yeah, so I love that she's a people's person. She doesn't mind whether, you know, you're somebody or you're nobody. If she has a time, she definitely interact with you. She's not one of those that says, I know I'm busy, or because of this person is of a lower status than I am, then I can't attend to them. Our office is usually open to the public.
What would be written on my tombstone? Okay, maybe like, here lies a very hardworking woman who wanted change in society, and who wanted the girl child to be up there. Here lies that woman.
As the district will be celebrating Women's Day under the theme Think Equal, Build Smart, Innovate for Change, Christine Chande Kalumbwa's projects to put up classrooms and health facilities using personal funds are leading the way for sustainable development. By working with everyone and bringing different stakeholders on board, the council chairperson is indeed building smart, innovating change, and balancing Masaiti for better.
They've seen what I'm doing. They've seen what I'm for. They know what I stand for by now. They know education is key, health is key for me. I build health posts, I build schools. So people will attest to that. They know, because I reach all those places where help is needed. So I think people will vouch for me on that, because they've seen what I'm doing. They've seen the work that I'm doing around the district. So this is an ongoing thing for me. I'll just have to continue. In or not in office, I will continue.